The Illuminati Formula to Create an Undetectable Total Mind Control Slave by Fritz Springmeier and Cisco Wheeler. Podcast 4. Chapter 3, The Use of Drugs. The science of pharmacology, drugs, has given the programmers a vast array of mind-altering and body-altering drugs. Some of the drugs are not used to directly alter the mind, but to change the body, make skin burn, or make the person vomit, or some other reaction that can be harnessed to further their nefarious programming goals. If they want a little girl to develop breasts, they might give her hormones. Neuroscientists are now familiar with chemicals which cause personality traits. If one wants to create raving paranoia, simply provide the brain with too much dopamine in the emotional centers of the brain and too little dopamine in the seat of reasoning area of the brain. Reduce serotonin in the person and the person will be unable to connect disagreeable consequences with what provoked them. In other words, they can't protect themselves from danger. Thorazine was used regularly at the CIA's Jonestown, Guyana group control experiment. Survivors of Jonestown have testified as to its effectiveness. After this gruesome experiment in mind control came to its end with a massacre, large amounts of drugs were discovered. Just one footlocker at Jonestown alone contained 11,000 doses. The authorities prevented chemical autopsies of the bodies to ensure secrecy of this sophisticated concentration camp, which was used for medical and psychiatric experimentation by the CIA. An examination of the drugs that are used in mental hospitals to alter the minds of patients offers a clear indication of what is being used in the monarch mind control programming. Drugs used for mind control. The CIA and Illuminati programming centers have more than 600 to 700 different drugs at their disposal. The following is a partial list of the drugs available for their mind control, aka MK Ultra programming. They can make a person feel like he is in heaven, or burning in hell. The drugs are at times used with elaborate light, sound, and motion shows that produce whatever effect the programmer wants to produce. They can make a person believe he is shrinking, or that he is double, with mirrors, or that he is dying. Before describing how drugs are used for programming and control, let us list a few which we know have been used. This list comes from CIA documents obtained from the Freedom of Information Act and from what multiples used as programmers remember. Many of the new synthetic drugs are known only to the Illuminati and intelligence community. Note, a rather long list of drugs is provided. It features at the end of this podcast for herbs. When the victim's body is saturated with all the drugs they can assimilate, they will receive herbs, which often have a drug effect. Ayahuasca, a vine of Brazil whose alkaloids such as telepatin are said to produce a telepathic state where the recipient can see through people like glass and read their minds. Bayberry, hemorrhaging. Calamaz, part of a cerebral tonic. Cayenne pepper, stimulant. Charcoal, absorbent cleanser. Caladium sequinum, injected into body parts to cause excruciating pain. Clove oil, placed in nose for relief from the pain of dental tortures. Hemlock, a poison, used more to kill than for programming. Hops, sleep aid aka beer flower. Lady's slipper, relaxant. Kava kava, sedative. Mistletoe, for dizziness, and lower blood pressure. Narcissus, an aphrodisiac for males. Opium, enchanting trip. Potions, made from roots, powders. Dried blood and animal parts are given. Rosemary, mild heart tonic. Saffron, sedative. Sage, part of a cerebral tonic. Sandalwood and henbane, when burned the fumes cause convulsions and temporary insanity. Skullcap, relaxant. Sunflower seed oil, this may be used to help with brain stem scarring. Valerium root, works just like valerium, also helps cramps. Witch hazel, hemorrhaging. Yerba mate, part of a cerebral tonic. A brief history of the use of drugs. Religious groups, shamans, medicine men, witches, and cults have been using mind-altering drugs throughout history. The medieval witches used potions of hemlock and aconite for their flying ointments. These are herbs, natural drugs, which will create delirium. Contemporary witnesses reported that covens during the medieval ages would apply the potion of hemlock and aconite to cause their new witch to go delirious, and then would transport the person to the sabbat, where they would be told they flew there. The Haitian satanic Vodou cult, which has been manipulated by the CIA/Illuminati, has sorcerers called bokers. The Vodou cult in Haiti is being used for trauma-based mind control. One of the items of the cult is to take the plant Datura stramonium and add this plant with other things. The plant is the active ingredient of a potent psychoactive drug, the zombie cucumber, which produces amnesia and a pseudo-death of the victim. The brain doesn't die, but the mind is shut off. The victim is brought back to life as a zombie, a slave of the boker. The powder to create a zombie is called zombificant in French Creole. The ceremonies to kill and resurrect the zombie are full of magic and demonology also. Magic, drugs and demonology have always gone hand in hand. Drugs remove the part of the will that prevents demonic possession. Drugs are considered powerful demonizing substances by those skilled in demonology. If demonic possession is seen as part of mind control, then cocaine, hashish, crack, and some of the other drugs are part of the effort to enslave people. The power of magic to kill, just as the power of faith can heal, will be discussed in Chapter 10. In Basutoland in Drakensberg's, the Zulu witch doctors use drugs and trauma to create tokoloshes, mind-controlled zombie slaves. It is said that in recent years, they are using less children and more baboons and monkeys to get tokoloshes. The point is that drugs have been and continue to be used by the occult world for controlling people. The intelligence agencies working through the U.S. government-financed drug research. An example is that Dr. Beecher of Harvard University was given via the U.S. Army Surgeon General's Office $150,000 to investigate the development and application of drugs which will aid in the establishment of psychological control. Research into drugs for mind control began in 1947 at Beta Satin Naval Hospital in Maryland. A CIA report described this research as to isolate and synthesize pure drugs for use in affecting psychological entry and control of the individual. At the California Medical Facility at Vacaville, Dr. Arthur Nugent conducted research into drugs for mind control under the auspices of the CIA. The Bureau of Narcotics worked with the CIA to establish safe houses where drugs which were seized were given to victims. Some other hospitals which began working with the intelligence agencies with dispensing drugs for mind control include Mount Sinai Hospital, Boston Psychopathic Hospital, University of Illinois, University of Michigan, University of Minnesota, Valley Forge General Hospital, Detroit Psychopathic Clinic, Mayo Clinic, the National Institute of Health, and Letterman Hospital in the Presidio, CA. The military did drug research/programming at the Army Chemical School in FT. McClellan AL and at the Edgewood Chemical Center. In 1958, Dr. Louis Gottschalk, working for the CIA, suggested that addictive drugs be used to control people. Some GIs who became addicted to pain-killing drugs were subsequently blackmailed by withholding the painkillers until they complied with the demands asked of them. Cocaine has been frequently given to monarch slaves to get them addicted and give their handlers more control over them. There is spray cocaine, and powdered cocaine, etc. Because the monarch slaves are used to haul drugs and to launder the drug money, they are right in the middle of large supplies of drugs. If you hear the expression "the snow is falling," it is the network's lingo for cocaine. Cocaine is reported to give people a feeling of power and to act as an aphrodisiac. Applications for drugs in programming. Drugs are used during programming. Although drugs used to assist programming mean nothing to the common person, they each have a specific purpose within a certain type of programming. Some specific uses for drugs during programming include putting people into trance, teaching alters to go deeper into trance to escape drug effects, enhancing the trauma, eroducing out-of-body experiences e creating pain, creating blood vessels that hurt, a pulsating pain that runs through the body, controlling histamine production, helping create illusions such as no hands, no feet, no face, no head, etc. Teaching altars to stay in position. To assist other programming modalities, such as high-tech harmonic machines, which implant thoughts. The machines are used in conjunction with designer drugs. Hormones, for instance GnRH, which regulates the physiology of the sexual growth, and is given to speed up sexual growth. Other body developments may also be manipulated. To enhance or reduce memory. To build the image of the programmer's power. At this point, it is appropriate to point out that the personalities of a multiple do not respond uniformly to the same dose of the same drug. Understanding how a drug will affect particular alters is a science in itself. If an alter is holding the body, it will receive more of the effect of a drug. Let's say paraldehyde is given to a multiple. A possible reaction would be that some alters will feel no effect, some will be sedated to a drunken stupor, and child alters may be unconscious or hyperactive. Chloral hydrate might put some alters to sleep while others remain wide awake. Sometimes the personality holding the body may fight the influence of a drug to keep the body. Prochlorperazine is sometimes given by therapists to help alters cope with nausea and vomiting. Most alters will be programmed not to accept drugs except from their master. Lithium suppresses alter switching in some systems. An alter to protect the system from the therapist's helpful medications may develop allergic responses. Alcohol is a drug. The reaction of an alter system to it will again be varied. Child alters may become unconscious, while the adult alters don't even become inebriated by large quantities of hard liquor. Within males, dangerous violent personalities may take the body. Within the medical world, often an approximate correct dosage will work. However, with the programming the doses must be extremely fine-tuned. Some of the best skilled medical doctors and assistants help with the programming. The Illuminati will initially give the small child a small dose of a drug. They will chart its effect, give it a urinalysis to see how long it stays in the body, etc. This is just the testing stage, they are not doing any programming. A number of drugs will be tested, but only one at a time. They clear a child's body of a drug before they give it another one. They prefer not to mix meds. They will start small to ensure they don't overdose and then increase the dosage until they notice the correct behavior pattern. This will be charted in detail on the slave's chart. Each child's body chemistry is different, so the suggested dosages are only ballpark figures which are not precise enough. If too much of a drug is given, the programmers can easily turn a child into a psychotic basket case. One of the secrets of the Illuminati / intelligence agencies is that they have secret antidotes for most medications, which, if they have to give them to a child, then they will. They will use an antidote, for instance, to keep a child from going into heart failure. The programmers will have some helpful drugs and herbs on stock too. It is reported that glutamic acid, 1000 mg 3 times/day, will take care of the intense headaches that alters get from lots of switching. Witch hazel leaves and comfrey root will help internal bleeding. Putting people into trance. About 90% of the population can be placed into the somnambulistic, the deepest, hypnotic trance possible simply by giving them hypnotic drugs. The prior list on pages 47 to 50 gives over 24 drugs that can be used to assist taking someone in hypnotic trance. Special drugs have been designed which will place someone into a deep trance very quickly. If an alter is not being cooperative when they are accessed, they can be locked in place mentally and given a quick shot of a fast-acting hypnotic-inducing drug. One drug which was popular for programming was Demerol, which would be administered intravenously, N4. It takes about 5 to 7 minutes to take full effect after administration via an IV. The dosage can be administered so that the effect remains until the programming session is over. It may be administered about every half hour if appropriate. Children will receive 1 to 2.2 milligrams per kilogram dose. Another drug, a truth serum, also consistently works on people, making them totally compliant to any directive. Under Baradanga, people will give their bank account numbers and anything else a person might want. These type of drugs are almost sufficient in themselves to get compliance out of a person. If one realizes that these drugs are used in conjunction to torture, elaborate systems of lies and deception, trauma bonds, and all the rest of the sciences of mind control used in the programming, it is easy to see how they are producing totally compliant human robots. Teaching alters to go deeper into trance to escape drug effects and pain. Much of the training in this area is based upon the child's horror and fear toward the all-powerful master programmer. When the programmer wants the child's alters to learn to trance deeper, he will give a drug that the alter doesn't like. The child's alter will then be told to go deeper into the mind if they want to escape the effect of the drug. This enforces the dissociative state being trained for the alter. The suggestion or storyline that is given to the alter is frequently the picture of a train. The child is told that the conductor is at the front of the train, but he must move to the back of the train through the train cars. The child is taught to count cars when they go by as if they were steps in the mind. This is training the child to descend into deeper levels of the subconscious. The train illustration has been used by programmers when they want the child to remember the drug experience. The programmer wants this experience remembered at least for a while because it helps increase the child's fear. If the programmer wants the child to forget the drug experience while learning trance depths, then the imagery of a plane taking off and disappearing in the clouds works. Enhancing the trauma. Drugs will be used to enhance the spinning effect when the mind is being programmed to have vortexes and to set up traps within the slave's mind. One particular drug enhances the trauma by 100 times. Drugs can be useful, for instance, to enhance a child's terror of the experience of this child being placed in a small box in the fetal position for 24 hours. This helps shorten the programming time, and it also makes the programming more intense. The programmers know what antidotes to give to pull the child out of the enhancement. Marijuana enhances perception of color and noise, but it is not used to enhance trauma. The mind does not program well under marijuana. That is why there has been such a big campaign to keep it illegal, even though many studies show it to be safer than alcohol. Producing out-of-body experiences. Various hallucinogenic drugs, LSD included, will produce an out-of-body experience for the victim, if the drugs are administered correctly. The programmer will prepare the victim with various information and storylines during the administration of the drug. Monarch slaves are being deprogrammed. They may have a memory where their skin feels inflamed and itchy, like a bad mosquito bite. The experience may also have the sensation of floating in an unreal world. This may well be an LSD trip given the slave during experimentation and programming. The CIA was using LSD beginning in the very early part of the 1950s. Several victims report that some type of potion causes a person to dream while they are awake. PCP, which is angel dust, is one way to disconnect the cortex from the limbic system and go into an altered state. Creating pain. This is done with a long list of drugs. Drops of salt water and pepper water are applied to the eyes of victims to make their eyes sting. Another pain in the eye takes place when lights are flashed signaling, I love you not. The child is pulled two ways by this message. Dr. Green, Manchel, enjoyed pulling daisy petals while saying these words. If the last petal was I love you not, the child would be put to death. Surviving children were left traumatized. Creating blood vessels that hurt. Blood pressure is raised by drugs and then certain drugs are added which make the veins burn. The alter is taught to cut the burning veins. This is programming which is laid in to control the slave from straying from the script he or she is given. If they stray, then a cutting program is activated which was laid in via a combination of drugs in the method just stated. Controlling histamine production. The control of histamine production is an important secret ingredient to the monarch mind control. The breast implants placed into women help stimulate histamine production, which is used in conjunction with drug-assisted programming, see Chapter 8. Helping create illusions such as no hands, no feet, no face, no head, etc. A programmer working with a hallucinogenic drug can make an alter believe that it has lost a particular body part. Because most of these alters have little memory or no memory and little frame of reference, what they are told while under the influence of drugs seems very real to them. Teaching alters to stay in position. Some alters don't like to stay in position. But through the use of drugs, and the side effect of drugs, they soon learn the importance of staying in position. If they are disobedient, the memory of the bad side effects from not staying in position in the mind can be pulled up by a code and the alter can relieve the pain from having disobediently moved from position. This is very effective in teaching alters to stay in their little position that is assigned them in the mind. To assist other programming modalities, such as high-tech harmonic machines, which implant thoughts, the machines are used in conjunction with designer drugs. An example of how drugs can be important is as follows. The neurons in the hippocampus, which is part of the memory process, use acetylcholine. Drugs that block acetylcholine interfere with memory. The neurons and the chemical neural transmitters are understood much better today. Where and how a thought is created in the brain is understood by the programmers in detail. No one is in a position to physically prevent the Illuminati and others from taking their children and others to labs where chemicals and harmonics can be used in sophisticated computer-guided ways to implant thoughts into the children's minds. As the child's brain is shaped according to its environment, the level of everyday brain chemicals and the shape of the various areas of the brain can be determined by the programmers. This is why a recent article on Prozac, Newsweek, February 7, 1994, uses a quote from Alice in Wonderland for its title, "One pill makes you larger, and one pill makes you small." This article, on page 38, quotes brain researcher Restock, "For the first time, we will be in a position to design our own brain." On the previous page in big letters it reads, "Scientific insights into the brain are raising the prospect of made-to-order, off-the-shelf personalities." Another programming modality assisted by drugs is behavior modification. Aversion therapy using a vomit-inducing drug is used on children. Another example of drugs helping assist programming is to give someone LSD and then interview the child while it is hallucinating. The hallucinations are then used as programming building blocks by using hypnotic techniques. One way to build on a LSD trip is to tell the child if they ever do a particular thing, such as touch programming, remember programming, and integrate parts, etc., the victim is to go crazy and hallucinate like they are presently doing. This means that they will be locked up in a crazy house for the rest of their life. Rather than be put in straitjackets with other crazy people, it would be better for the person to commit suicide. By constantly reinforcing this message, some alters will adopt the script that they are doing the body good to kill it if any alter personality touches the programming, because otherwise the body will be locked up in a crazy house. Drugs are used in programming to establish a pattern or a script. There must be a pattern of dissociation. Parts can't just dissociate into nothing, otherwise there would be nothing to build on. Drugs will play a major role in the structuring of the alter system, which is covered in Chapter 7. The child doesn't know where the effect of the drug is coming from. The programmer will take credit for the power of the drug. Whoever administers the drug has power in the child's mind. The mind wants to be safe. I am familiar with a recent example here in Oregon of someone who escaped from being sacrificed at a satanic ritual. The legal system told the woman she was crazy when she reported to the police that she had escaped from a satanic ritual where they were going to sacrifice her. To control her, the judge ordered three types of antipsychotics, twice the normal dose of two kinds of lithium carbonate to put her into a lethargic stupor, Paxil as an antidepressant, and benztropine mesylate as an antiparkinsonian agent. The antipsychotics were thiothixine, thioridazine hydrochloride, and profenazine, which are all addictive. This woman may or may not be a multiple. But this clearly shows the type of mental control via drugs that could be slapped onto someone who dares report satanic activity to an establishment which has been sadly corrupted from top to bottom. One victim of government mind control tried to get free. The first psychiatrist the person tried to go to was cooperating with U.S. intelligence and gave her stilazine, which aggravated the victim's situation. When the victim spied a general's uniform in the closet of the psychiatrist, she got another psychiatrist, who unfortunately turned out to be an ex-employee. He placed her on Haldol decanoate, clonopin, and benzatropine. The combined effect of these drugs is to erase memory, and create a dissociative disorder. All of the drugs were highly addicted. Another fleeing victim was given trazodone by a physician who was cooperating with the intelligence agencies. This almost gave the victim a heart attack because it aggravated her heart condition. And yet another escaping victim apparently also fell prey to dirty CIA doctors who were practicing in public without warning people of their intelligence connections. This victim was given a combination of Compazine and Xanax, in dosages that the physician's desk reference warns against. The doctor, who prescribed this, worked out of an office named after an MK-Ultra programmer. There are other important things to mention about when drugs are used in monarch programming. Some of the cautions that the programmers are alert to include: A. Watching the heart so that it doesn't stop. Many of the children who have been programmed have died from heart failure. The programmers are very careful to have heart monitors on the victim, and to have paddles ready to revive the body. Because so much of their drugging affects the heart, they accept that they will lose a few to heart failure. B. Making sure that drugs aren't given to children who are allergic to them. The programmers take the time to ensure that they have the family histories of allergies to drugs, and they will test the children too, before proceeding with drugs. They not only learn the family and individual responses to drugs, but they can test during programming to determine a drug's blood level in a child. For instance, pentobarbital at a blood level of 5 mcg/ml aids hypnosis, at 15 makes the victim comatose with reflexes, and at 30 makes the person comatose w/extreme difficulty in breathing. In everyday life, 30 micrograms per milliliter would kill the child. Pentobarbital blood levels can be tested by an enzyme-multiplied immunoassay technique. For longer-acting phenobarbital gas chromatography is used. TCAs are tested by radioimmunoassay, high-performance liquid chromatography and thin-layer chromatography. Some hypnotics are tested by colorimetry, photometry, and spectrophotometry. C. Switching to herbs when the body is saturated with drugs. When the child's body has had all the manufactured drugs it can absorb, the programmers switch to a vast collection of natural herbs. D. Providing the antidote for AIDS. Monarch slaves are routinely given the antidote for AIDS and have been since the 1960s to 1970s. E. Knowing how much of a drug each part can take, small young alters can't take as much. Multiples within a single system have varying levels of tolerance toward drugs. A small child alter may be killed by an adult dosage, even though the age of the body is that of an adult. The programmers are acutely aware of how to deal with multiple personalities. F. Providing salt to balance the electrolytes in the mind of a programmed multiple personality. An electrolyte imbalance can cause a multiple personality's mind to go wacky and start spinning. The multiple could possibly go into shock and die. The programmers are very experienced in understanding the unique requirements of a multiple personality. G. An important plant extract for watching brainwave activity is the large plant enzyme horseradish peroxidase, HRP. Perhaps it would be worthwhile to briefly mention that all the major chemical and drug companies are run by the Illuminati. It would take a book to explain who controls what and how they connect in, and this author could write it. Instead, we will try to give a quick overview. Rather than cover 24 large drug companies, three major drug companies have been randomly selected to show a quick view of how all the drug companies are deeply involved with monarch mind control programming. Since the purpose of this book is to show how the mind control is done, this sample of names is given only to convey to the reader that the drugs that the Illuminati slash intelligence agencies need are never in short supply, and the labs to develop designer drugs for mind control are not in short supply either. Eli Lilly Co. Trustee of Eli Lilly Endowment Walter William Wilson, Illuminati, married to Helen Scudder, of the wealthy powerful Scudder family, prominent partner of Morgan, Stanley, and co-controlled by Henry Morgan, also a member of the Illuminati. Executive Vice Pres of Eli Lilly Landrum Bolling, represented Eli Lilly at the secret annual Dartmouth conferences, overseen by the Illuminati. Chairman of Eli Lilly Richard D. Wood, D.I.R., of the Rockefellers Standard Oil, Chemical Bank of New York, and the AMER Enterprise Inst. For Public Policy Research. D.I.R. Eli Lilly C. William Verity, Jr., Director of Chase Manhattan Bank and associated with U.S. Intelligence, and works with Mrs. Rockefeller as a member of USDEC. Dan Quayle and George Bush, CIA Director and Monarch Handler, have been part of Eli Lilly management too. Monsanto Chemical Company President Earl H. Harbison, Jr. CIA, and Director of Bethesda General Hospital where they program Monarch slaves. He is also the President of the Mental Health Association. Sterling Drug Company, an IG Farben spin-off, connected to the Crook Illuminati family. Chairman W. Clark Wesco, Director of the Super Secret Tinker Foundation, which is a CIA foundation. Gordon T. Wallace, Illuminati, Director, of the Federal Reserve Bank of New York, CFR, Director Martha T. Muse, CIA, President of the Tinker Foundation, Director of the Order of St. John of Jerusalem, Knights of Malta, and Director of Georgetown Center for Strategic Studies. Summary. As the reader can see, the use of drugs in the Monarch trauma-based mind control is extensive and requires skilled technicians, nurses, and doctors. Because of the long-held control by the Illuminati families over narcotics and drug manufacture and sales, there is no difficulty for the programmers to get large quantities of secret designer drugs. The minor occult cults have to get by with a more limited supply of mind-altering drugs, unless they directly connect in with the bigger picture. The power of drugs to control a person's life is not absolute, although someone who lives with a cocaine addict or alcoholic might disagree, but when coupled with all the other methods in a sophisticated system of mind control, drugs just further reinforce the absolute power of the Illuminati over an individual. Here follows the list of drugs previously noted at the beginning of this podcast for 2GB, aka CBR. This is a strong hallucinogenic which also helps telepathic communication. 2CT2, produces dark, earthy visual patterns. Acetylcholine, for EEOM, EDOM, and for blocking memory. Adrenaline. Actetron. Alcohol. Ambien. Aminazin. Amobarbital, hypnotic sedative. Amobarbital sodium, hypnotic sedative. Amphetamine, addictive. Amphetamine sulfate. Analacine. Anectin, succinylcholine, a strong muscle relaxant that makes one feel suffocated and drowning. The person feels terror at thinking he is dying. Anhalamin. Anhalidine. Anhaline. Anhalonidine. Anhalonin. Anhalonium. Aphrodisiacs. Sexual manipulation by programmers. Aphelidine. Aphelin. Aprobarbital, hypnotic sedative. Atropine, speeds heart rate given with LV. Atrocine. BZ, designer drug 10 times more powerful than LSD, produces amnesia. Bambuza. Banisterine. Baradonga, truth serum which makes people willing to follow any command. Barbiturate. Belladonna, a traditional drug of witches since the Middle Ages. Benzedrine, benzdrine, stimulant used with other drugs. Benzocaine. Bromoharmine. Bulbocapnine, causes a catatonia and stupors. Butabarbital sodium, hypnotic sedative. Butylbromyl barbituric acid. Caffeine. Caffeine sodium. Calcium chloride. Cannabidiol. Cannabinol. Cannabis, aka marijuana, a sedative, change in perception, colors and sounds more distinct, time distorted. This drug is not used much in Monarch programming because it impedes mind control. It has been experimented with in combination with other drugs as an interrogation tool. The CIA listed it as being used in MKUltra, but it served as an experimental drug rather for programming. Cannabol. Carmine. Carboline. Carbidol. Caroegen. Chloral hydrate, a hypnotic sedative, the active sedative ingredient is the metabolite trichloroethanol, goes to work in about 30 to 60 minutes, aka Noctec. Cocaine, addictive, blackmail, the availability of cocaine may pull up certain alters who are addicted to it. Coffee. Coramine. Curare, to paralyze the body. Delvinyl sodium. Demerol, a hypnotic, also given as a reward for good learning after an induced headache, is used in the scramble programming where the victim must overcome its effect to concentrate on what is being said. Desoxin, used with sodium pentothal for hypnotic trance. Dexedrine, amphetamine. Dibenzopyrin derivatives. Dicane. Doral. Dramamine, aka dimenhydrinate, stops motion sickness. Drobinol, for quick access. Ecstasy, aka XTC, Atom, MDMA, this is an illegal designer drug. But it's used by the government and cult programmers. Empathogens, like ecstasy, enhance trust between the recipient and the programmer. Its effect lasts for several hours. Ephedrine, stops hypotension. Ephetamine. Epinephrine, adrenaline. Ergot. Ergotamine. Ethanol, to inebriate the victim to induce certain behavior. Ethchlorvinol, hypnotic sedative. Ethylharmol. Epicane. Escrin. Estazolam, hypnotic sedative. Ethchlorvinol, hypnotic sedative, effect begins 30 minutes after digestion, addictive, aka. Placidil. Ether. Ethanamate, hypnotic sedative, aka Valmid. Yucaine. Yucodil. Yucodil. Unicron. Evapil. Evapan. Evapan sodium. Flurazepam hydrochloride, hypnotic sedative. Genoscopolamin. Glutethamide, hypnotic sedative, has withdrawal symptoms, aka Doradin. Halcin, blocks explicit memory by impairing hippocampal processing. Haloperidol, tranquilizer. Harmaline. Harmalol. Harmon. Harmine. Harmine methiodide. Harmol. Heroin. Hexacol. Histidyl. Histamine, causes changes in the skin. Hydractin, or hydrastine. Hypoloid soluble hexabarbitone. Icoral. Indole. Indole methylamine. Insulin, shock for amnesia. Ipecac, to induce vomiting for eating disorder programming. Largatal, a powerful tranquilizer. Lofop9. Lorazepam, sleep induction, may destroy memory of previous day. LSD-25, used to program alters to cut their veins, they want to end their nightmare by cutting what seem like white rivers with black threads or other scary delusions. Can cause psychosis and other effects. It's used in small amounts for interrogations. Its active ingredient is psilocybin, which can create anxiety and a fear of death. Lascorbic acid. MDA, this is a cross between mescaline and amphetamine speed. MDMA, also known as Atom, this is ecstasy, see under ecstasy for more information. MDE, aka Eve, puts someone into a strictly intellectual head trip. Manganese chloride. Melaril, mood changer. Methaqualone, hypnotic sedative. Methotrimiprazine hydrochloride, hypnotic sedative. Methicocaine. Methiprilon, aka Noludar, helpful for hypnosis, side effects are a hangover and skin rashes. Metriol. Midazolam hydrochloride, hypnovel, versed, hypnotic sedative which can cause amnesia. Morphine. Morphine hydrochloride. narcoimal, nembutal, niacin, helpful to stop an LSD trip, nicotine, nicotinic acid, stops LSD drug effect, nycthemin, nitrous oxide, novocaine, nupurcaine, pantocaine, pantopone, parahyx, paraldehyde, hypnotic sedative, produces sleep in 15 millimeters. Has a strong odor and disagreeable taste. Pelotine. Pentobarbital, hypnotic sedative. Pentobarbital sodium, hypnotic sedative, if mixed with dextroamphetamine sulfate it will have the stage 1 dream time when REM sleep occurs. Pentothal acid, helpful for hypnosis. Pentothal sodium. Percaine. Pernostin. Peyotl, interrogation, hallucinations. Fiactin. Phenamine. Phenolic acid, injected into expendable children's hearts to kill them. Pethylthiourethanes. Picrate. Picrotoxin. Procaine. Propranolol, calms the mind so it can function better. Pulagonorsinol. Pulagonolivitol. Pyrahexyl. Pyramidon. Quazepam, hypnotic sedative. Quinine. Reserpine. Salzoline. Scopolamin S. Effective amnesia drug. Scopolamin, truth serum that makes people willing to do whatever they are told. Scopolamin aminoxide hydrobromide. Scopolamin phetamine ucotyl. Secobarbital sodium, hypnotic sedative. Sodium amytal, hypnotic sedative that reduces REM sleep time. Sodium barbital. Sodium dialvinyl. Sodium evapil. Sodium pentobarbital, nembutal. Sodium pentothal, truth serum for interrogation, can be used with hypnosis, can be used with desoxin, given in an IV. Sodium phenobarbital. Sodium rodinate. Sodium sonaryl. Sodium succinate. Sodium thioethamyl. Somnifen. Stoven. Strychnine. Stephnic acid. Sulfazin. Sympatol. Sinhexyl. Telepathine. Tetrahydrocannabinol acetate. Tetrahydroharmin. Tetrahydroharmine. Tropicocaine. Tropinin. Timazepam, hypnotic sedative. Thallium, confuses thinking. Thorazine, helps bring one out of an LSD trip. Tranquility, a designer drug for programming that makes the victim compliant. Like Baradanga. Triazolam, hypnotic sedative, somewhat rapid. Yegane. Yohimbine sulfate. Zolpidem tartrate, hypnotic sedative.